Hello everyone, welcome to episode 3 of Q&A series with Suresh GP.
Hi, welcome to this episode on DevOps. In this section today, we're going to talk about two key aspects: toolchain, CI/CD pipeline, and also about Azure DevOps. As you know, we collect the most commonly asked questions by our viewers and make this as an opportunity to clarify some of the misconceptions and areas to get more clarity in how we understand and apply DevOps. So one of the things that we have seen in our earlier episode one was around the concept of DevOps being more focused on velocity and stability. On the aspect of automation, we have an important element which is called CI/CD pipeline, which means right from the beginning of design, build, test, deploy, how do we perform for releasing new features faster, safer, and secure. Now, one of the most important part when we try to do software delivery is to make it more consistent. So in order to make this consistent delivery possible, you need to build a standardized pipeline. Now, what is a pipeline? As I said, you have different phases in the software development lifecycle, from planning, which is planning your workload, to designing your application, your features, your building, which is coding aspect of it. Then you do testing. So all types of testing, like unit testing, integration testing, security testing. And then you deploy the code and release it, right? So the entire aspect has to be standardized so that the teams can consistently release features at every 2 to 4 weeks as part of sprint without any hassles. So if we need to build a pipeline, we need to focus on all those practices, right? Continuous integration, continuous delivery, continuous deployment, and continuous testing, continuous monitoring, all the 7 practices that we discussed in the last episode. So if we need to look at this entire platform together, we need to have a set of tools. So the pipeline would need some tools to be utilized at different phases to make this happen. And that is what we call as a tool chain. A tool chain is a set of tools that help to achieve the design, build, test, deploy end to end. Now, this tool chain can be of 2 options. One, a single unified tool chain, which is like, you get that, we deploy it. There's not much of customization possible. It falls under the trap of jack of all trades and master of none syndrome. So many times it doesn't really work because we have some integration challenges that might not really go well when you opt for an all-in-one DevOps tool chain. One of the things that we have seen in client engagements is a part of a customized tool chain. So depending on your niche, every organization has got a center of excellence. This center of excellence decides on the best tools that they can opt for at different phases. So for example, you can use tools like Jenkins for continuous integration. You can use SonarQube for a static application security testing. You can use Puppet for a configuration management tool. You can have GitHub as a source code repository. So you can actually look at various aspects. Now, what are some of those popular aspects where you use tools? Version control. Every tool today has got this opportunity to decide on which code are we running around. Continuous integration, which is you're checking in the code every day, once a time to see all the code merging done. Configuration management, where we are providing some of those environments using Chef, Docker, Puppet. Deployment, right? So you use tools like Udeploy or Excel Release to deploy the piece of code into production. You use containers Now, containers are nothing but you write your code once and run it anywhere else. So one of the popular tools are Docker. So you package everything together, right? The source code, the binaries, everything together and deploy. And then we have our infrastructure as a code, like Terraforms, AWS CloudFormation. Then we use monitoring tools like Prometheus, combined with Grafana. And then we use our testing tools like Selenium, which helps you with test automation. So entire tools can be decided by the center of excellence. Now, as we go through this, we also have two set of options. One is open source tools, and the second one is proprietary or vendor-related tools. Now, open source tools give you the flexibility to go there and explore options which can make modifications at the source code level. But remember one thing, open source are not really free. Open source code needs to have a dedicated team to explore those options. Then there is a combination of proprietary tools. Like for example, there is a licensing of a particular thing. For example, you use OpenShift as opposed to Kubernetes, right? So OpenShift is from Red Hat and you have license involved around it. So many of the organizations have a combination of both open source code tools as well as vendor proprietary related tools as part of their tool chain. I hope that answers your question about pipelines and tool chain. Now you have to understand, when you develop the tool chains, it is not that you need to have tool for every aspect of the phase. Generally, you start with something small and build it cohesively so that you can make this more sustainable. Now, the next question people ask us when it comes to elements is about Azure DevOps. Now, I want to start with a premise. Whenever you talk about DevOps, you need to first understand the philosophy of DevOps, which is the cultural and professional movement where we bring in all of the teams together to focus on stability and velocity and security part of it. Then we need to get into the science, which is more about the different practices that we have in terms of continuous integration, delivery, deployment, and all of those practices. And then we get into the engineering part of it. Now, the engineering part of it is what we call as tool chain. So start with the philosophy, then the science, and then engineering. Because otherwise, a fool with a tool is still a fool. So if you are keen to start your journey in DevOps, first understand the philosophy, then the science, and then get into the engineering aspects of it. So one of the starting point is to do a course on DevOps Foundation from the DevOps Institute, because it gives you a very good holistic understanding about culture, automation, lean, measurement, sharing, and tool chain, which is very, very important to get a holistic understanding. So it's a two-day course that will give you a fundamental basics about doing certain things. So don't assume this, because you knew a tool, you're a DevOps engineer. Now let's talk about what is Azure DevOps. Azure DevOps is a platform and it's provided by Microsoft. So Azure DevOps is a popular continuous delivery platform and orchestrator. So simply think about as a software as a service. The benefit of a software as a service is, and particularly on Azure DevOps, it provides an end-to-end DevOps tool chain for developing and deploying solutions. So it can integrate with a lot of other tools in the market. Now, what does it do for developers? So it will help you right from planning your work, that means your backlog. Then you go to collaborating on code development, building and deploying applications, working together and deploying products and services. So there are two options available. You can either do it on cloud, which is in the form of Azure DevOps services, or on-premise, which is Azure DevOps server. So if you look at some of the advantages of doing Azure, Microsoft being a very popular platform gives you great, reliable, scalable, and globally available solutions that makes it much more interesting for us to do. I know most of you would have something like Microsoft Office 365. You will have Microsoft Teams. So one of the advantages of Azure DevOps, it integrates all of those components seamlessly for better collaboration, communication, working in a manner to deploy services efficiently. And what kind of options do you have? So as I said, this Azure DevOps is a platform that looks at end-to-end. And it doesn't matter which tool you use, it allows you the flexibility to integrate it with Jenkins, Puppet, Chef, Docker, whatever you have, seamlessly into that pipeline. Some of these features that you can explore in Azure DevOps is the Azure Boards. So the boards are more from a planning perspective, like what are the features we're going to do it? What is the backlog? How are we going to move from the left to right? It could talk about pipelines, which is what we talk about, the continuous integration, continuous delivery, continuous deployment aspect in the way we work. It could also build Azure artifacts, which is similar to what you have in making sure that the source code is compliant before it is getting deployed into production. It also gives you Azure test plans, so you can provide test automation in a manner that it could move seamlessly without defect passing downstream. Last but not the least, it also has something called Azure Marketplace. Now, Azure Marketplace gives you an exposure to integrate with third-party systems. So that way, you are not inherently dependent on just Azure. It gives you a flexibility to make this work very well. Now, one of the things as we start to work with Azure DevOps is to also understand that the end goal is so important. So as part of doing this pipelines, it's also important to ensure that security is not compromised. So Azure platform also gives you a compliance dashboard. So if you are following your PCI DSS, which is Payment Card Industry Data Security Standards, or NIST Cybersecurity Framework, or ISO IEC 27000, which is for information security management, all of those stuff can be written as your rules that needs to be complied, and it will tell you how much of these rules have passed in your pipelines. So holistically, Azure DevOps gives you a holistic understanding about the pipelines, the standardization, integration, and ensuring that velocity and stability is achieved. So if you are thinking about whether Azure DevOps knowledge is essential, it is absolutely very important skill to acquire as we start to build our capability around DevOps. I hope that this conversation that we had today helps you understand about pipelines, the CI/CD pipelines, the tool chains, the do's and don'ts, and also about Azure DevOps. I hope you found this useful, and we will join you back again in another episode talking about most often asked questions. So if you have any questions that you would like us to answer, please feel to comment on the link, and we will be more than happy to get this over. Do not forget to subscribe to our channel and to our podcast to get notified on our upcoming series. Thank you.